What's up, Prize Five fans? I'm Brian Tong, and e-readers continue to be a red-hot product, so we're throwing two CNET Editor's Choice e-readers into the ring. It's a Prize Five punch-out between the Amazon Kindle Paperwhite with special offers and the Barnes & Noble Nook Simple Touch with glow light, both priced at $119. Our judges for this fight are Executive Editor John, the Maltese Falcone, Executive Editor David, the Bad Boy Carnoy, and myself, Ring-a-ling-a-ding-tong. Now we'll take all three judges' scores and average them out to the nearest 10th each round. The final prize fight score will be an average of all rounds using the same system. We're going five rounds deep. First up is design. Amazon's Kindle Paperwhite streamlines its design with an all-black border that takes design cues from the entire Kindle family. Its minimalist design brings a soft rubber backside, and it's about 20% thinner compared to the Nook, but a little heavier in weight. Now the Nook Simple Touch with glow light has a unique e-reader design with rounded corners accented by a gray border and a contoured booty design that's more ergonomic and comfortable to hold. We wish it was a little thinner, but its smaller footprint is still nice. I like curves, but the judges overall give the Kindle Paperwhite the edge with a perfect 5, and the Nook glow light gets a 4.7. Next round is navigation and interface. The Kindle Paperwhite removes all physical buttons except for a power button at the bottom. The lack of a central home button at the bottom means you'll always have to change your hand position whenever you want to access your toolbar by tapping at the top or even turning on the built-in light. That can be annoying. Now, its all-touch interface uses a capacitive touchscreen for turning pages with a swipe, and it's overall a tad bit snappier to use. Now, since we're comparing the special offers version, you'll always have a banner on your home screen and your screensaver, so that can take away from the experience. Now, the Nook brings both touch and physical control navigation. When reading books, you can move through the pages by either touching or swiping the screen or using the physical controls on the side to turn pages. Pressing the center brings up more settings and options. The home button is the heart of the navigation, easy to access, and it brings up the main toolbar. Plus, holding it down activates the glow light for reading, and overall, the feel and controls here are just better. The Nook gets a perfect 5, and the Kindle gets a 4. So after averaging two rounds, the Nook takes the lead. Next round is features. The Kindle's biggest feature is its new screen with the Paperwhite built-in light that's brighter and is lit a little more consistently. Plus, its screen resolution is higher for slightly crisper text. Now, my favorite reading feature is X-ray mode that breaks down important characters or locations, but it's not available for all books, and time to read lets you know when you'll finish a chapter. Now, you won't find a headphone jack or speakers anymore, but you'll still get an experimental web browser that I recommend you never use, ever. Now, another killer feature is Amazon's lending library, and if you're an Amazon Prime member, you'll have access to 180,000 books that you can borrow, including the entire Harry Potter series, and that's huge. Now, the Nook Glow Light was the first e-reader to bring the backlit screen that set the standard, and it still works great, but it's a tad bit behind now that the Kindle has caught up and improved their screen resolution. But the Kindle can't match the Nook's SD card expansion slot for storing more content. You can go into a physical retail store and read a selection of books for free, and native EPUB support is a big deal for hardcore users. It also comes with its own power adapter. You can't say the same for the Kindle that just has a USB cable, and you won't have to look at special offers all the time. Both e-readers support OverDrive for borrowing books from local libraries. They can both lend books to other users. There's PDF reading support and social hooks for Facebook and Twitter. This round's jam-packed with features, but the Kindle takes it with a 4.7, and the Nook gets a 4.3. Next round is performance. The Kindle brings a pretty ridiculous 8-week battery life with the backlight on. That's just dirty good. It also has a higher resolution screen and is slightly faster to navigate compared to the Nook. Now the Nook has a 1-month battery life with the glow light on, and that's impressive, but just not as impressive. The Kindle Paperwhite takes this round with a 4.3, and the Nook glow light gets a 4. So after averaging four rounds, we're tied at 4.5. The final round that decides it all is ecosystem. If you've ever heard the phrase, content is king, this is where Amazon shines. Amazon has 180,000 Kindle exclusive titles and often offers slightly better prices, but you'll pretty much find the top books on both stores. Now, Amazon's lending library is also a huge differentiator if you pay for Amazon Prime. Both e-readers offer books, magazines, and newspapers, and you can even download games on your Kindle. Barnes & Noble just can't match the Amazonian beast when it comes to content, and the Kindle takes this round with a 4.7, and the Nook Simple Touch with Glow Light gets a 4. So let's average out all 5 rounds, and in a battle where the Nook Glow Light came out hitting hard, the Kindle Paperwhite fought back hard, taking the last 3 rounds, and the new kid on the block takes this battle 4.5 to 4.4 and is your Prize Fight winner. I'm Brian Tong. Thanks for watching. We'll catch you guys next time on another Prize Fight.